Hello, everyone. Thank you for tuning in to the Agency Weekly Video Podcast. So we miss you. We hope everyone is staying safe, healthy, and washing your hands more than two times a day. But we decided to want maybe to host these weekly podcasts just so that we can stay connected with you all. And most importantly, want to cover some important topics. Let's first talk about the importance of self-tape. I can tell you that there is so many talents right now, or just overall, everyone is really overlooking the importance of these self-tapes. The industry is now trending towards self-tape, especially with what's going on. You must invest into a home studio so that you can get these self-tapes out to us in a timely manner. Understanding the difference in submitting for theatrical projects, because it's not the same like when you're submitting for commercial. And then I want to introduce you guys to Amanda.
So glad you guys could make it. Basically, we are basing the session around the questions that you guys sent in to us. So thank you for sending those in. So hopefully we will be able to answer all those questions that you sent in. But if by the end that we haven't got to your question yet, and or you have some new questions, don't worry. We're going to have an open Q&A session where you can ask all the questions that you want to, and hopefully we'll be able to answer them. And I'm also going to be sharing a poll with you guys so you guys can let us know what topics you want us to cover in the next following weeks as well. And I'll give it back to Kim to talk about self-tapes.
A good quality self-tape has the potential of being shared with other casting directors, producers, decision makers in the industry. And this can lead to more booking opportunities. So don't overlook the self-tape. The self-tape is extremely important, okay? Example, I'm going to share with you an example where talent initially had auditioned for a project, let's say with Sony. But a week later, I had the same casting directors called and wanted to book that talent for another project, which was Apple. You know, it happens, and it happens all the time. Another important key factor is your resume. If you have not already done so, please make sure you take some time. Update your resume, include any training, any recent bookings that you have. Please make sure you list them on there. Now, the ones that are actually very new, does not have a lot of experience yet, I want you to think about what on-camera experience that you have done in the past, whether it was in school, training for as a trade, for fun, you know, etc. Make sure you list them on there. Even after when things go back to normal, please do not disregard the importance of a self-tape. You know, not only that it helps save time, both for the talents and the casting directors, but you don't have to drive to LA through the LA traffic, save you money on gas. And it most importantly, you're in control of how you want to showcase your skills.
Kind of some things that you want to keep in mind when you are doing your self-tape. The first one is really, really important, and it's going to be you want to make sure that you're filming horizontally. So you have a wide angle shot, and that means that when a casting director plays it back on their computer or their laptop, they'll be able to see you fill up their entire screen. That means that if you have a phone, you want to flip it sideways so that you're not filming vertically. Unless the casting director like specifically asks you, which is very, very rare, to film it vertically, then always, always, always film it horizontally. Super, super important. The next thing that we're going to cover is framing. There's going to be three common framing shots that will be asked of you in a self-tape. The first one is going to be the profile shot, and that basically means that they want to see your full body profile and your full body proportions. They basically just want to know what it is that you look like, and you want to make sure that when you are filming this, you are still having your camera horizontal. So if you are in a situation where you don't have enough space in your apartment or your house and you still to like film that full body shot, then we have two options for you, or two solutions to hopefully help you. The first one is going to be, if you can, go to another location that's outside of your apartment or your house. This could be in your backyard or at a friend's house or maybe at work, where you have enough space to be able to have that horizontal wide angle shot but still show your whole body. Film that, save it, so that for all the other self-tapes in the future, you can use that exact same shot again and again and again, and you don't have to worry about re-recording it every single time. You can use it as long as your body doesn't change. Once it does start to change, then you want to make sure that you update it accordingly. The next one would be, if you have no other options, then we would suggest you find a hallway or maybe your kitchen if it's really long, somewhere in your house that gives you some distance to walk back and forth, and to set up your camera so that it's wide enough of an angle that they can see your whole body, and then walk away from the camera and then walk back towards the camera slowly so they can see your entire proportions. Just make sure you let them know that what you're doing before you do this so they don't get confused, and make sure that you keep this until the end of the video if this is how you're going to showcase your entire body. The next is going to be the medium shot. This, I think, is the most common shot that is used, especially for theatrical when you're doing a scene. And a medium shot basically just means that you're shooting from the waist up. And last is going to be a close-up shot. I think this is mostly used for the commercial and for makeup brands or skincare brands. They just don't really want to see your skin. So this is going to be from shoulders up. Next, I'm going to talk about the background. So a lot of people, when they focus on self-tapes, they focus on what you're presenting, what you're bringing to the self-tape, but they forget about what's going on behind them. That's also really important because you want to make sure that there's no clutter. If there's trash in the background, if there's dirty laundry in the background, if there's stuff that will distract from your performance in the self-tape, you want to make sure you get rid of that before you film. And if you are lucky enough to have a backdrop, or you can, you have one in your house, or you have a blank wall in your house. But if you do have a backdrop, make sure there's no wrinkles in it, because that can also be really, really distracting. And last, but definitely not least, is going to be lighting. So you want to make sure that you have really, really good lighting so that they can see your face and what you look like. The lighting should be soft so that it complements your skin tone. If it's too harsh or if it's coming from the wrong angles, it's going to cast shadows that's going to block certain areas of your face, and you won't be able to showcase, or they won't be able to see the expressions or what it is that they're trying to accomplished through the self-tape. So you do want to make sure that you keep in mind the lighting. If you don't have lighting equipment, make sure that you plan enough time so that you can plan your self-tape or film your self-tape when it's light out, and make sure you find the brightest spot in your apartment that can give you the best lighting in your video. But I'm going to be talking a little bit more about equipment at the end to talk about things that you can purchase to make your life a little bit easier in terms of self-tape. And now I'm going to bring it over to Kim, and she's going to talk about the difference between a commercial and a theatrical self-tape.
Okay, the difference between commercial and theatrical self-tape. Commercial, they want you to showcase your personality, any specific skills that you have. It should be friendly, energetic, confident, and not so robotic. Remember that this is your first chance to show your personality and how professional you are. Share some relevant experience into that brand or that role that you're actually going into audition for. And that's for commercial. Commercial, you always want to start, smile, introduce yourself, and be authentic and show your personality. For theatrical, it's going to be a little bit different. You know, they're always going to ask you to slate. Slate means a quick introduction about yourself, but not diving in about your hobbies, unless if they ask for it. So the slate is just basically a quick introduction of your name, basically like your headshot photo coming to life, you know. And the slate should be different. It's not a one-size-fit-all type of slate for theatrical. Let's say if you get called in to do a scene that's very dramatic, wartime. So your slate should not be preppy, commercial, happy, smiley type of slate. It should just be authentic, but still you. So you got to be able to know how to gear your slates to be very natural, very inviting, but yet be mindful of the scene that you are about to perform. Now, for your scene, you do not want to look directly straight into the camera. You do want the camera to be at eye level, and that you, it's super important that you look either to the left or to the right. Okay, and the framing should be as suggested in the self-tape. Normally it is medium shots or either the close-up shots. It is important that you have a reader. What is a reader? A reader is someone else that is actually reading your opposite scene. Now, we get a lot of these common questions. I don't have anybody to read with me. What are we going to do? I think Zoom is an amazing platform that everybody should actually start networking with other talents from the agencies or people that's in your class or other actors. Have them to actually read for you over on the other side and maybe simultaneously record a scene together. That would be amazing, right? Important thing for self-tape, for theatrical, is that you follow the self-tape instruction. If they're asking you to label them and separate the files, then you must do that. If they're asking you to upload them and send them over in a certain type of links or format, such as WeTransfer or Dropbox, then you must do that. You do not want to send them or upload them in onto Facebook or maybe YouTube, because you don't have permission to do that, okay? So you want to make sure sure the theatrical self-tape submission, it is not forgiving if you don't follow the instructions. So make sure you follow the detailed instructions that is provided.
So basically some key things you want to make sure on what to wear for a self-tape. A big thing is you want to make sure you don't blend into your background. So if you're standing in front of a white wall or if your backdrop is gray or black, make sure you're not wearing those same colors. So you want to make sure you pop out so that they can see what you look like. And make sure it's nothing too loud with really big logos or really big writing on it. Make sure it's very simple, tasteful. That's the best way to kind of go. Also, a good rule of thumb is if you have clothes that's a little bit more form-fitting so they can see what your body looks like, nothing that you really drown in, but something that can show your figure. And if you want to show like a certain sense of style, you can layer on with like jackets or blazers or anything that really fits the character. It's really not necessary to wear like a costume unless it's specified by the casting director. And something that you also want to keep in mind is makeup, not just for the ladies, but also for the guys. You always want to be camera ready. So you want natural makeup. You want makeup that will cover anything that may not look the best on camera, which is just like your under eyes. Sometimes we look tired. I know I always look tired. So just putting some under eyes can brighten that area up and make you look a little bit more alive. Good full coverage, long lasting makeup is also really good, especially if you have really bright lights. You want to make sure that you look the best that you can. And also, once you do add all of that coverage on, it can tend to drown out some color from your face. So make sure you do moisturize your lips and tint it with a little bit of color. Don't go too overboard, but just a little bit just to see that like, okay, I'm natural. This is me, camera ready, and this is what I look like. And I think that's a good rule of thumb. And next, I want to talk a little bit briefly about the equipment resources that we have for you guys. Like Kim mentioned, I'm going to be sending out an email with a PDF on all of the equipment that we recommend that you can get. If you have means to do so, just know that having an in-home studio should not break the bank. It should not be super expensive. You don't really have to spend that much money if you have, if you set it up in the correct places, right? But a lot of people have asked, should I use a camera or is my smartphone okay? Your smartphone is perfectly fine. If you have a camera, that makes your life a little bit easier and you're a little bit more flexible in terms of like features that your camera has. But if you just have a smartphone, just be sure to flip it sideways and you're good to go. We're going to be talking about like audio. Make sure your audio is clear. There are lav mics that you can buy that are super cheap online. They just plug into your phone, clip to your shirt, and then you'll have clear audio. Next, lighting. Like I mentioned, lighting is so important, but you don't have to have something super expensive. Just a simple ring light would suffice. Kim mentioned that she has a specific ring light that she likes to use that you can just clip onto your desk and it provides beautiful light so you can film yourself self-tape at night if you aren't able to do so during the daytime. And lastly,
$25. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
That's okay.
Really how like budget friendly it is. So it's not, you know, don't get discouraged, guys. Like, we have to be able to set some sort of competition of these self-tape videos coming up next weekend.
Yeah. And then the last thing is going to be backdrop. So if you are interested in purchasing a backdrop, I'm also going to include that into the PDF. Just be sure that it is wrinkle-free and make sure when you do buy a backdrop that you buy a color that does not interfere with a ton of clothes that you have. So if all you have is gray clothes, don't buy a gray backdrop. That's just a good rule of thumb. But cool. I think that's all the things that we have today. We're just going to wrap it up for now. And we're now going to open the forum to any questions that you guys might have.
So while we wrap this up, we do want to be able to conclude that we're going to actually have a contest, okay? The contest and the challenge is going to be, I want you guys to actually create and produce your self-tape introduction video. Send it over to the agency, and we are going to select three top favorite videos, self-tape videos. This should include a quick introduction about yourself, and we're going to send you what that sample should look like. If you speak any other language, then make sure you include all that in, and we are going to feature them onto our next week podcast. So I hope this you guys find this video informative, and we really look forward to seeing your self-tape video submissions, and let us know if you have any topics or any questions that you want us to basically cover. We want to be able to be here and provide you with that support system that you would, that we will all need right now. And we look forward to connecting next week.
Cool.
Yeah. Thank you.